Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. Coming up here on today's show, week two grades after a huge Monday Night Football win, 34-24 over the New Orleans Saints. The Raiders, they get that first win in Allegiant Stadium. They move to 2-0, and I don't know about you, I am so freaking hyped right now. And if you're hyped too and you bleed silver and black, go ahead and subscribe to the Raiders Report. We are the number one most watched Raiders channel on YouTube. We're going to be keeping you updated on the latest news, rumors, daily videos, and I'm going to be live Tuesday, 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific. So go ahead, click that big red button, because I've been told we are an A-plus show. Let's get into some of these grades. These are going to be grades that you'd be proud to put on your mom's fridge. The offense, they're going to get an A-minus grade for me. Remember, A-plus is absolutely perfect. I'm going to be a little bit more critical here with my grades. The reason why I'm giving them an A-minus, yes, they were able to move the football, but there were still some points there, a bad fumble by Jalen Richard, and also some opportunities where you could have scored more points. So for me, I am going to be a little bit more critical here. This is a solid, though, A-minus grade. If you're watching this live or if you're in the YouTube comments, let me know. I want you to type offense, give me your grade here. Seeing a lot of A's, seeing some B-pluses come in, 34 points scored, total yards 375. The most important stat that I didn't feature is the amount of plays. The Raiders, 57 plays. The Saints, only 39. The offense was able to sustain long drives, killing a lot of clock, keeping the defense off the football field. They had one bad turnover. If it wasn't for the Jalen Richard fumble, I might have given the offense an A grade. If it wasn't for them not being able to convert earlier on in that first quarter, might have given them an A plus. That's why I gave him an A-. Let's go to the defensive side of the football here. I'll tell you what, after a 10-0 start, after a 17-7 start, I'm like, oh my God, I'm going to have to give him another D. You know what? I'm going to give him a B-plus grade here. And I couldn't quite give him an A because they still gave up 24 points. You still gave up a decent amount of yardage, over 400 total yards. But you did come away with a takeaway, one interception, but no sacks. There was no pressure whatsoever on Drew Brees. That was hard to see. But I will give my tip. I will tip my cap to Paul Gunther. I will tip my cap to this defense and say you made some adjustments. For you to be down 17-7 on Monday Night Football against one of the best teams in the National Football League, and then for you to realistically hold them no points for about 2.5 quarters, I salute you. So for that, you get a B+. Let's go to special teams now. What grade are you giving special teams? You know what? I'm going to give you an A-plus grade because when it came down to it, when it comes down to being a kicker, and Daniel Carlson, damn it, I'm looking at you. When it comes down to being a kicker, if you can make a 54-yarder when it matters the most, you're going to be hanging around in the NFL for a long time, my dude. Special teams, you get an A-plus grade. So what I want every single person to do right now, I'm going to make this the pinned comment on today's video. I want you to grade the Raiders' performance versus the New Orleans Saints. A, hey, you guys have been to school before. At least I hope you have. A, B, C, D, or F. For me, I'm going to give the Raiders a solid A, maybe A-minus grade. Coming away with a win on Monday Night Football. That's big time. That's what big time playoff teams do. They did it. So scroll on down. Let me know. Grade the Raiders' performance versus the Saints. Next player up is going to be Derek Carr. If you watch the game, you know where my grade's going to go. He gets an A-plus from me. If you're a Derek Carr hater, and if you blame him after today's game, shame on you. Shame on you, shame on you. He was excellent. The offensive line was not very good. They had no running game, realistically. He goes 282 yards, 3 touchdowns. Super efficient. He completed the pass to 11 different receivers. Yeah, that's the DC we know and love. Let's go to the running back now. Josh Jacobs left a little bit with an injury, did come back. I'm going to give him a B grade. And the reason why I'm giving him a B is because if you'd ask Josh himself, he'd actually probably give himself a C. But we did come away with a win. He was very, very heavily involved in this one. Had 3 catches. Also ran the ball 27 times. I mean, when you're talking about a player who touched the ball, 30 times, and the offense ran basically, 59 plays, yeah, you're definitely going to give Josh a solid grade here. So he didn't break the big one, But he at least had to scare the defense, which opened up a lot of things, especially for the next player that we're about to dive into here. But before I dive into my next grade, what I want you to do, go out and get yourself a Show Me Those TDs touchdown. So even though Josh Jacobs didn't find the end zone, Derek Carr threw for three. And if you're looking to be able to say to somebody, hey, show me those TDs, and I've been in Vegas before, it's happened. Now, I will say the only time I've seen TDs in Vegas was from some crazy nun on Fremont Street Experience, which I don't recommend to anyone. It was fun, maybe not her TDs, but I'll get serious again. My mind, super crazy. Chatsports.com/TDs, show me those TDs t-shirt is available. Someone who did show me a TD, it was Darren Waller, and another player who gets an A+ grade from me. I mean, spectacular. The only Raiders player with over four targets, and he had 16, comes down with 12 of them for 103 yards and a touchdown. Henry Ruggs only had one catch for 4 yards. Josh Jacobs was kind of bottled up, but you saw Darren Waller. He was the main focal point of today's offense, and even though Bryan Edwards only 52, Hunter Renfrow only 37, you saw a lot of these other players didn't get catches, but they opened things up for Darren Waller. So what I want you to do right now, fill in the blank. Let's play a little bit of a game here. Blank, player's name, impressed me the most against the Saints. It can be offense. It can be defense. Let me know which player impressed you the absolute most versus the New Orleans Saints. If you want to know what player I would go with, I want you to hit me up on IG. I'm at Mitchell Renz 365. Time now to go to the defensive side of the football. I'm going to talk about my man, Jonathan Abram. He's going to get an A grade for me, and I'm not going to be too strict because Abram, to me, he scared the bejesus out of me when he's like trying to make a tackle on Kamara, goes down, and he's just laying there. And I'm like, oh my God, is he unconscious? He hops back up. He runs back out onto the football field. Four tackles, one pass breakup. Last week, he had 13 tackles, which, I'll be honest, I definitely thought he was going to have over five. Five and a half was his over-under. But just flying all over the football field, continuing to show pressure, and just played overall a pretty solid football game. So Jonathan Abram, I'll tell you what, I'm giving him a good A grade. Let's go to the linebacker position now, and it's tough being a Raiders linebacker. And some of you might get mad at me for only giving Nicholas Morrow here an A- grade. But at the end of the day, to me, he got beat a lot over the middle. He gave up a lot of receptions to Alvin Kamara, and I get it. It's not an easy job to do, but he did come down with a very clutch interception, which opened things up. But also a player who I'm not going to mention on today's great show is Malik Collins, who Malik Collins is the reason why Nicholas Morrow came down with that interception, because the inside pressure from Collins basically opened things up. And then for Nicholas Morrow, he had seven tackles, a pass deflection, and a clutch interception. He gets an A- grade from me. I saw a lot of people in Las Vegas were celebrating, and I hope you are. If you're looking for the exact same face mask that John Gruden had on tonight that players wear for the Raiders, you can get it. It's available for you at chatsports.com/RaiderMask, okay? Raiders mask is the link. You know what? We'll put it in the comments. It'll also be in the description, chatsports.com/RaiderMask. Let's go to the next player here, Damon Arnette. This is a prime time game of what I think we're going to see from Arnette, who I'm going to give him a B grade. Let me know what you would give Arnette. I'm seeing some A pluses from Arnette. I can't do that. That's not even close to me. I'm going to give him a B. And before halftime, I had Arnette down as a D. And why did I have Arnette down as a D? Because Tre'Quan Smith had four catches for 80 yards, and he was roasting Arnette. Then he comes back out in the second half, allows only one catch for 6 yards. So Tre'Quan Smith finishes his day, 5 catches, 86 yards. So Arnette made some changes. The Raiders defense made some changes there. And ultimately, you go into half, you go down, giving up 4 catches for 80 yards. You make a big-time decision. You make a big-time change, allowing only 1 catch for 6 yards. So yes, Damon Arnette, big-time change there. B grade for me. So what I want you to do right now, just type Raider Nation for life in the comments, because it feels good. It feels very, very good right now to be a Raiders fan. If you went to Las Vegas, I'm super jealous. I wish I could have went. But unfortunately, crazy times lead to crazy things. But I will say this, I am very, very proud of this football team. Raider Nation, what's going on? Is this the number one Raiders channel on YouTube? For Chucky Heads, believe it, baby. And if you haven't already, subscribe right here. I'm giving you Chucky Heads news, rumors, Raider Nation rumors. And look at this. I'm making your life easier. Check out my next video. Thanks for watching, and go Raiders.